Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video, we're talking about something called Notion Shuffle Time. Notion Shuffle Time is a word that I've dedicated to essentially the act of you moving around the blocks and pages inside of your Notion account constantly. And I want to talk about the ways that you can reduce your time spent on this, and also why that's the case, why we spend so much time on doing this act of moving stuff around. So guys, that's gonna be in today's video. So hey guys, welcome back to another video. I've got a nice cup of tea here. It's Becca's work mug that she's recently bought, so maybe I might get told off if she sees this video. Fingers crossed she doesn't. But today's video, we're actually talking about Notion Shuffle Time. And the reason why I want to talk about this is because a lot of people in the Facebook group are mentioning this. They spend a lot of time inside of Notion, moving their stuff around. And I totally get where they're coming from. As a Notion user myself for a year and a half, I've literally explored like moving my Notion account all around and new layouts and things like that. What I want to do today is talk about the reasons why, how you can reduce it, and also talk about how that came to plan and from the other applications that we've used in the past. So let's start by talking about Notion. Notion is a modular application, so you can change it up to whatever style you like. Now in the past, with the applications we've used, like Evernote, Todoist, Trello, they've had some form of structure, some sort of organized, fixed layout that you've gone into and you've just added the resources. Now naturally, let's take Evernote for example. You've had notebooks, you've had tags, you've had stacks that you can add, shortcuts even, but nothing to the extent of Notion of being able to completely recreate your productivity application. And naturally, a lot of people are going to spend time in these applications like Notion, like Coda, and like Mila Note 2. Now, team applications like Monday.com, like Coda, like Airtable, are a bit easier when it comes to the sort of structured layout. So they also have very similar structures to Notion, but when you're with a team, when you're with 3 or 4, maybe 10 people, you have a sort of obligation to create a structure and then leave it as it is until your next review. Because if you change that structure during that period of time you're working on a project, you could potentially damage the process or flow of the project, and that sort of defeats the act of teamwork and team collaboration if you're constantly changing your team application structure. So teams aren't necessarily going to struggle with this. It's going to be the people who use Notion as a personal experience, like you and me. Now the reason why this is so damning is because imagine if you constantly changed your Notion account, maybe 45 to an hour and a half a day. Add that up across the week and you're looking at a lot of time that can be spent maybe on the task or elsewhere. Now, why I want to help you to reduce that time is because we have to try and think of Notion as this application very similar to the ones before, but we have to limit ourselves, I guess, on how much time we spend in the application. Now, my sort of recommendations for you, if you're thinking this is a problem for you, and it might not be a problem at all, is the following. So major changes to your Notion account, and we're talking about structural changes to maybe your homepage or a page, should be done and limited to 30 minutes per week. And this could be spanned across the week. Now, I would say the one thing you need to do with major changes is be intentional. One thing that I do inside of my Notion account is make notes at the bottom of a page in order to let myself know what areas I want to create. And the goal behind that is so that at the end of the week, when I actually come around to making those major changes, I can actually get activated and not necessarily in the moment. For example, let's say I just jumped into it in the afternoon and started building out a page. It takes me another 20 minutes. But if I condense it or block it into one period of time where I'm changing all of my major changes on Notion in a week and dedicating 30 minutes to it in that block, then I know that I'm at least being a bit more frugal on how much time I'm spending on major Notion changes. The other thing I do is daily Notion tweaks, because tweaks add up over time. Like, you could tweak the color change or the color background on a bit of text that you've got. You could be adding an additional table and linking it out, etc. There's loads of things you can do. Cover pages are where a lot of time is spent. Try to limit yourself to 10 minutes a day. Maybe that's 3 minutes in the morning, 3 minutes at lunchtime, and 4 minutes there. But try and limit actually changing the experience inside of the application, because you're just going to delay yourself and even spark new ideas about how you can do major changes inside of Notion. So as I was mentioning, I sort of make a tally of things that I need to improve inside of my own Notion as I go, instead of necessarily doing it in the moment. That's almost like capturing articles to read later versus actually reading them in the moment. Now, the other recommendation I have is, if you want to change your design for a homepage, and let's say it's the evening and you have got your laptop stowed away, or you're wanting not to do a bit of work, then what my recommendation is, and what I'm going to be doing very soon a worksheet on, is actually just getting a bit of paper and actually just sketching out what you want that page to look like. Now, Notion is very, like, almost like a page. You're adding things, you're building things in that page, and sketching it out, even if you are naff at sketching, rubbish at sketching, then use the page as almost like a workspace to design something that you can recreate later. So this can almost help you in that process of delay. Anyway, guys, naturally, this is going to be an interesting space. Once we create modular apps, you're gonna get a lot of problems with it. Naturally, you've got templates inside of Notion, so that's gonna save you a lot of time, but I do think it's gonna be something we're gonna notice in the next 6 months, people spending a lot of time inside of Notion, making it look dope. And this is actually something that has occurred in the bullet journal space. A lot of people have done bullet journals, but they redesign it every single month, which isn't a problem, because there's a lot of value in theming it to a certain thing that you're doing and limiting that time. But this is something that we have seen before inside of notebooks. So it's definitely worth looking at how that, because I almost guarantee it, that's how Notion's gonna play out. Anyway, guys, let me know in the comments below, how much time do you spend averagely a week on Notion? Let's not judge each other. Let's just give each other a figure. Where would you like to work towards? It'd be great to hear. Maybe we can recap this video. I'm also doing daily videos now, for this next month at least, so feel free to pop in any comments of more videos you'd like to see on Notion or other such applications, because I'm probably going to be in the comments a bit more often. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.